We continue now at the top of Daf Mem Hey with Aleph and Meseches Eruvin. This is Eruvin Daf 45a. The Gemara here is discussing Rabba's position. Rabba says that Havloas Techumen Lav Milsehi, which means that you cannot have the merging together of different Techumen if one of the Techumen happens after Shabbos already starts. In other words, if you have one Techum before Shabbos, then you get a different Techum after Shabbos starts, you're not going to have Havloas Techumen. So the Gemara now asks, is that really true? But we learned in the Mishnah later on, Rabbi Eliezer says, Shtayim yikones gimel lo yikones. We just mentioned this on the previous Amud. If a person is just two amos away from his tchum, he's allowed to enter into his tchum. Once he's three amos away, it's a problem. Rashi here explains, Misha yotza chutz l'tchum beiz amos yikones. Somebody's outside of his tchum, two amos can enter in. Abel gimel lo yikones. He can't do three. My high shiura did not get. What's the reason for this shiur? What is this two amos? Lav Rabbi Eliezer l'tayme. Isn't it Rabbi Eliezer, according to his opinion, Rabbi Eliezer holds that when a person gets Dalet Amos, question how to measure that Dalet Amos. So he holds the Hubem Tzon Sheyesh Lo L'chol Tzid of Beiz Amos. Rabbi Eliezer holds you don't get four Amos in every direction, you actually get two Amos in every direction, which is an equal to an area of four square Amos, but you don't get four Amos in every direction. Well, Afikach Zeshe Yotze Beiz Amos Chutz L'tchum. So now Rabbi Eliezer says, therefore, somebody who goes two amos outside the tchum, kevin de beiz amos of devukos lo betchumo, since now it's a merging of these two tchums. You have his current tchum, which is two amos, and you have his old tchum, and he holds, severely Rabbi Eliezer, to command the muvlin betchume damu. Rabbi Eliezer holds that you have this absorption, one tchum and the other, they merge together. Umutr likanes, and it's mutter for him to enter the tchum, alma milsi. You see that it is, in fact, a good merging together. Rashi here points out this works better according to the Lishna Kama. There were two versions of what it means to merge the Tchum. Rashi, as he goes on, says, Lishna Kama havet yuft, according to the first Lashon, this works beautifully. Aval Lishna Basra lo nehirali, says, I don't understand this proof according to the second Lashon. Daloka asri le mahadir, because nobody said you can't return. Uman de garis lo mefarish, de kevon de ha lo havam uvlos, ela devukos. The person who says the second Lashon will have to say that in this case, it's not really muvlos, it's just touching. They're not actually overlapping. They're just touching one to the other. Afilu hachishari, we're still allowing it. Shvami na havlo dover gadolu. You see, it's a dover gadol. They can go that far. Vehecha de mivlon chad tchum ahave. And when they would overlap, then you'd even get one. You'd get a larger tchum. You'd even get an even larger tchum than you had before. As we said before, in that second lashon, if you hold havloas tchum and milsi, it means not only that you go back to the original tchum, it means that it actually merges together. You get like a double tchum. So the proof is, if you get a double tchum, that means that it's a really big deal. And if it's a really big deal, so if they're touching each other, so then that's also going to work. In any case, so that's what the Gemara says. My lav, Rabbi Eliezer Lataimi, isn't that Rabbi Eliezer follows his reasoning? Diyamar v'hu bem tzon. He says that you get only two amos in every direction. V'yar ba'amos diyahavale rabbonan command de mivlon damu. And the four amos, it's like it's mivlon. Either it's over, so to speak, overlapping or touching. V'kamar yikanes. And he says you're allowed to enter alma havlas tchum and milsi. You see that this concept of the absorption of the tchum is something. That's a kash and rabba. Amale Rabba Bar Barchana le Abaye. So Rabba Barchana said to Abaye, "Umid Rabbi Eliezer kamos v'zalei lamar." Are you asking a question from Rabbi Eliezer against the master? Rashi says, "Umid Rabbi Eliezer os v'zalei lamar ha'pligi Rabbanan aleb masnisin." Rabbi Eliezer is not the only shita there. The Rabbanan disagree, so you can't ask a kasha from Rabbi Eliezer on Rabba. Amar le, he said, "In yes, I'm asking it the shmiya li minei demar because I heard that the Rabba said." Even the Rabbanim don't really argue with Rabbi Eliezer. They only argue on Rabbi Eliezer when it comes to a situation where you left the tchum for non-mitzvah purposes. On your own, for a voluntary situation, you decided to leave the tchum. So there, they are strict in that case. But if it would have been a mitzvah, they would admit that Rabbi Eliezer is correct. And apparently there is avlos tchumen. Rashi over here says, "Ledvar mitzvah module umasnisin demishiyotze bereshus dvar mitzvah." And our Mishnah that we're talking about, our case, you are leaving for a mitzvah. The Kama Rabba le'el to have lo lomahanyan. Still, Rabba said the have law is not working. So really, it's not only a kasha from Rabbi Eliezer; it's a kasha from the Rabbanon as well. And the Gemara now continues at the two dots. V'chol hayotzen lahatzil chozrin lemekomon. Someone who goes out to save—that means for war purposes—they can go back to their original tchum. Gemara says Vafilu Tuva, they can go back even if they went more than 2,000 amos. They're allowed to travel more than 2,000 amos back to the original Tchum. V'amrit Reishal Payim Amav Asulo. The beginning of the Mishnah says you get 2,000 amos. Wherever you're informed that you're not needed anymore, you only get 2,000 amos from that spot. It is true that towards the end of the Mishnah, it says that if your new Tchum overlaps with the old Tchum, okay, then there's a possibility to go back to your old position. But you certainly don't get more than 2,000 amos. So the Gemara answers, Amar Rav Yudah Marav. Rav Yudah says in the name of Rav, Shechozrin Bechle Zayin Lemekomen. What it means is not that they can get more than 2,000 amos. It just means that they can carry their weapons with them. Maybe you would think they should leave their weapons. No, they're allowed to carry their weapons back to the original place. Rashi says, Lo Tema Afilo Tuva De Lo Shari Alapayim. They only get 2,000. We don't say, well, since the battle is over, they should leave their weapons and not carry them. They shouldn't be mechal Shabbos. The Gemara is going to explain the reason momentarily why they're allowed to carry their weapons back. Gemara says, Umay Kushya, but what is the difficulty of you're asking a contradiction here in the Mishnah, where the Mishnah at the beginning says 2,000 amos, but if you go to save at a war, it seems like you get more than 2,000 amos. Dilma lahatzil shani, maybe when you're saving in a situation of a war, of a battle, maybe that is different. Maybe we're more lenient. Rashi says, Dilma lahatzil shani, misha yotze birashos demas nisin. When the Mishnah says you went out with permission, you were allowed to go out. Ikol ukme be'edus hachodesh uvachachma habo'a lele. That might be talking about you're testifying about the new moon. Maybe it's talking about somebody who's helping a woman give birth. But somebody who's going to save from enemies, we have a real concern, the enemies will chase him. In such a situation, even more than 2,000 amos. There really is no internal contradiction in the Mishnah at all. So the Gemara says, you're right. If there is to ask a question, we ask the following question. It's not because we learned in another Mishnah. It says that in the beginning, they actually didn't move at all. Rashi says, Lo hayu zazen misham biyotzen chutz l'tchum l'hayr al achodesh. Talking over here about when they leave the tchum in order to testify in the new moon. Ma'ari b'meseches Rosh Hashanah, that's what we're talking about over there. Lo hayu zazen d'misha yotza chutz l'tchum ein lo ala dalan amos. They said in the beginning, you only get 4 amos, you don't get to return. That's what they originally said. Hiskin Rebbe Gamliel Hazaken, and then Rebbe Gamliel Hazaken made a takana sheyesh lan alpayim amo l'chol ruach. That no, they can get 2,000 amos in every direction. Not only that, even in a situation, someone helping for a woman to give birth, somebody helping to save from a battle, from an army, from a river, from something falling down, a building falling down, a wall falling down, or you're saving from a fire, they become like the people of the city, and they get 2,000 amos. Now, this Mishnah says very clearly that you only get 2,000 amos even when it's a situation of a battle. So here we ask the kasha, Vesulo, you only get 2,000 amos, nothing more. But it says in our Mishnah, that if you go out to save in a situation of a battle, you go back to your original spot, even if it's more than 2,000 amos. So that actually is the contradiction. And on that, Amar Rav Yehuda Amar Rav, Rav Yehuda says in the name of Rav, Shechozrin Bechle Zayin Lemekomon, they're allowed to even return with their weapons. That's really the chiddush over here. Yes, they only get 2,000 amos. Our Mishnah just means that they can return with the weapons. Kedetanya, as we learned in a brayso, Bereishono Hayu Manichin, Klei Zaynon Bebayis HaSamach L'Chom. In the beginning, they used to leave their weapons in the house that was near the wall, meaning the house that was that the closest house, the first house they found. They didn't take it all the way back to their original city. Pamachas Hikiru Behen Oivim. But there was one time when the enemies saw what they were doing, V'Radvu Achareim, and they chased them. V'nichnesu, and then they entered this house, Lito Klei Zaynon, to get their weapons. V'nichnesu Oivim Achareim, and then the enemies entered after them. Dochku Zezeh, they were pushing against one another. V'Hargu Zezeh, they killed one another, meaning even the Jews killed one another. Yosem Mimash, Hargu Oivim, Bosashah, more than the enemies killed at that time. So it was a very dangerous situation to require them to put their weapons in the first house that they found on their way back. So therefore, Hiskinu Shu Chozrin L'Mekomon Bechli Zaynon. Therefore, they said, from now on, you're allowed to return to the place that you're returning to with the weapons, and it's not going to be a problem anymore. Rav Nachman Bar Yitzchok gives a different answer. Again, how come in one Mishnah it says they only get 2,000 amos, in the other Mishnah it says they can go back to their original city even if it's more than 2,000 amos? He says, lo kash, it's not difficult. Kan shenitzchu Yisrael asuma sa'olam. In one situation, we're talking about a situation where the Jewish army is the one that wins the battle. And in that case, we're going to be a little stricter. Rashi says, Nitzchu Yisrael, Alpayim Vesulo, they only get 2,000 amos. There's much less to worry about. They've been victorious in battle. So in that situation, we're more strict. Kan shenitzchu umos ha'olam asatzman. But if the umos ha'olam win the battle, Rashi says, nitzchu umos ha'olam chozun l'mekomon afilu tuva. Then they can go back to their original place, even if it's more than 2,000 amos, and it's not going to be a problem. And the Gemara continues, Amar Rav Yehuda Amar Rav. Rav Yehuda says in the name of Rav, Nochrim shatzaru ala yoros Yisrael. Let's say you have non-Jews placing a siege on a city that belongs to the Jews. And Yotzen aleihem bechlei zainan. We're not allowed to go out against them with weapons. Vein mechalin aleihem es ha-Shabbos. We're not allowed to be mechal Shabbos. Gemara will explain this momentarily. Tanya nami hachi. The Gemara says, we have a brisa like Rav Yehuda Amar Rav as well. What does it say? It says the same thing. Nochrim shatzaru v'chulu. You have non-Jews are sieging the city. This is only true if they're coming for money. If they're not coming to take lives, so that's the situation where you don't go against them with weapons and you're not mechal Shabbos. But if they're coming to take lives, you can go out against them with weapons. As a Shabbos, you're allowed to be mechal Shabbos as well. Now, if it's a city that's near the border, even if they're not coming for issues of life and death, they're not trying to kill, even if it's something as small as business dealings with straw, you're allowed to go out against them with weapons, and you're allowed to be Mechal al Shabbos. Omar Rav Yosef Bar Manyumi, Omar Rav Nachman, Rav Yosef Bar Manyumi says in the name of Rav Nachman, Ubovil kir hasmuchel esfar damya. Bavel is like a city which is near the border. There's a Jewish town in Bavel that's near the border between the Jews and the non-Jews, V'tirgama Nahardoi. And then what are we talking about? What city is that? It's the city of Nahardoi. Darsh Rabbi Dustoi d'min Biri. Rabbi Dustoi from Biri darshan this follows. Ma'idichsiv, what does it mean when it says in the Pasuk, V'yagidu l'David leimor, they told David saying, Hine plishtim nilchamim v'ki'ila, behold, the plishtim are fighting in Ki'ila, V'hema shosim es hagronas and granaries. Tana, we learned in a braisa, Ki'ila ir hasmucha l'svar haisa, Ki'ila was a city that was near the border. They were coming for straw. It says, what were they doing? Plundering the granaries. And it says, David asked Hashem, saying, should I go and should I attack the plishtim? And Hashem said to David, yes, you should attack the plishtim, and you'll save Ki'ila. Gemara says, "My kami boile." What was David HaMelech's question? If he was asking whether it's permitted or usher to start this war, Hare Beis Dino shel Shmuel Haramasi Kayim. The court of Shmuel was around at that time. Go ask Shmuel. Elo I mitzlach ilo mitzlach. Rather, what he was asking was, is he going to be successful in this war? Dekanami, we even have a proof to this from the pasuk. Dechsiv, because it says, "Lech v'kisav aplishnim v'hoshato es ki'ila." It says, "Go attack the plishnim, and you will save ki'ila." That means that was the issue that he wanted an answer on. Shema Mino, we see from here, indeed, that was the question that David HaMelech was asking. The Gemara continues with the Mishnah, Misha Yoshev Baderech. Well, let's say a person settles down on the road, he's traveling on Shabbos, or Shabbos is coming. V'yomad V'roah Harehu Samach L'ir. Then he gets up and he sees the very place where he was sitting, he was actually close to a city. Ho'el V'lo Haisa Kavanaso L'kach, since he didn't intend to make his Shvisa in the city, even though he's within the tchum of the city, but if he didn't have in mind, if he didn't realize he was near the city, lo yikones, he cannot enter the city. He has to just take 2,000 amos from wherever he was. Divrei Rabbi Meir, that's the opinion of Rabbi Meir. In other words, the point is he can enter the city within his tchum, but he can't be like the people of the city, as Rashi says. Lo yikones l'ir lios ka'anshe o'ir. He can't be like them. Elam imakam shechash chalo moded al paim psios beinonios v'ad makam shekalo yikones. He just measures 2,000 amos. That's all he gets. Wherever they end, that's where it ends. That's all the opinion, again, of Rabbi Meir. Divrei Rabbi Meir. Rabbi Meir says, you didn't have kavana, therefore it doesn't count. You're not part of the city. Rabbi Yehuda, Omer Rabbi Yehuda says, Yikonis. He may enter the city. He can become part of the city. Omer Rabbi Yehuda, Rabbi Yehuda says, Ma'i Sahaya, there was even a story. V'nichnas Rabbi Tarfon below Miskavin. Rabbi Tarfon entered the city without having any intention. He did not realize when he settled down that his makom shvisa was within the tchum of the city. Gemara says, Tanya, we learned in a braisa, Omer Rabbi Yehuda, Rabbi Yehuda says, Ma'isab Rabbi Tarfon, Shaya Mahalich Baderech. There was a story with Rabbi Tarfon. He was walking on the road, V'chashcholo, and it became dark. Shabbos came. V'lon chutz l'ir, and he settled outside the city. L'shachris, then in the morning, Mitza'uhu roe bakar. People who were grazing cattle, they found him. Amrulo, they said to him, Rebbe, Rebbe, Hareo ir lefanecha. The city is right in front of you. He kanes. Why don't you just enter the city? So Nichnas, he entered the city. V'yosha v'beis ha-medrash. He sat in the beis medrash. V'dorash kol ha-yom kulo. And he darshaned all day, and Rabbi Yehuda saying, it's a proof, we have a proof from Rabbi Tarfon, that even though he didn't realize he was within the tchum of the city, he gets to have the tchum of the city. So they Amru Lo, they said back to him, Misham Raya, you think that's a proof? Shema Belibo Haisa, maybe he did have it in mind. How do you know what he was thinking? And further, O Beis HaMedrash, Muvla B'soch Tchumo Haya. Maybe the Beis Medrash that he went to was within his Tchum. Maybe it was within his 2,000 Amos. Who says that he took the Tchum of the people of the city? Rashi says, B'libo Haysa, K'shu Yashav Sham Haya Yodeya. When he settled overnight, he knew Shu B'soch Alpayim L'makom Shvisaso, that he was within 2,000 Amos of the area where he was settling. The Gemara continues with the Mishnah, Misha Yashin Bederech, somebody falls asleep on the road on Friday, below Yodat Shechashech, he doesn't realize until it gets dark outside, he wakes up, suddenly it's Shabbos, he fell asleep when it was supposed to be the time that he was being Konim Makom Shvisa, Yeshlo Alpayim Amal L'chol Ruach, he gets 2,000 Amos in every direction, Divrei Rabbi Yochanan Ben Nuri, that's the opinion of Rabbi Yochanan Ben Nuri. Rabbi Yochanan Ben Nuri is lenient over it, he says, even though you were sleeping at the beginning of Shabbos, you still are Konim Makom Shvisa, and you get 2,000 Amos in every direction. The Chachamim say, Ein lo ala arba amos. No, he only gets 4 amos because since he fell asleep, he had no kavana to be kona shvisa and he doesn't get anything. He just gets the regular 4 amos, the minimum that anybody gets. Rabbi Eliezer says, V'hu bem tzon. When we say he gets 4 amos, he's in the middle, meaning he gets 2 amos in every direction. That's the same Rabbi Eliezer we quoted at the top of the Amud. Rabbi Yehuda says, Le'ezo ruach sheyirtze yelech. Rabbi Yehuda says that any direction he wants to go, he can go, and he chooses his 4 amos. Rashi says, La'ezer ruach sheyirtze yitol dalet amos. Pick a direction, that's where you get 4 amos. Ve'achar shebiro lo letzad ze in yochel lachzer v'liver letzad achar. Once you choose one direction, you can't go choose in another direction. That's the opinion of Rabbi Yehuda. Whichever one he wants. Umoder Rabbi Yehuda admits, shebiro lo, once he chooses, sheino yochel lachzer again, he's not allowed to change his mind. Hayushnayim mixas amos of shelzeh besoch amos of shelzeh. Let's say you have 2 people, they each have dalet amos, and they have 2 amos overlapping. So one of them, let's say they're 6 amos away from each other. This guy's got 4 amos to the east. The other guy got 4 amos to the west, and they're 6 amos away. So what's going to happen is 2 of those amos are going to overlap. So in such a situation, mevi'in va'ochlin be'emsa, they could bring food into that 2 amos that they share, and they can eat in the middle. And we'll continue this Mishnah in the next video on Daf Memhei Amud Beis.